Good afternoon, and welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to Skyrim. So I'm here back at High Hrothgar with Ezra, because she is just a pain in the ass when we take her into battle, so let's go get rid of her and see what they've got. I guess he's never seen a chest before. Hey! No, not you, you asshole. He's driving me insane, by the way.
I'm still following you, but I'm keeping my eye on you. We better get to Argus soon.
We're at Argus. I found Ezra. By the nine, you did. Ezra, you're still alive. I see you met a new friend here.
Yes.
Yes, I ended up sneaking past the border patrol and got into the pass. Then all hell broke loose and the Stormcloaks attacked the fort.
It was all I could do to find a place to hide.
She didn't check it. It was all I could do to find a place to hide. I hoped that the fighting would die down enough for me to sneak through, but it just seemed nonstop. Luckily, our friend here came along and got me out in one piece. I suppose I owe you an apology, but we can't be too careful with assassins being after us. Here, you can have this. It's a key to the catacombs under Fort Pale Pass. I was planning on going back there after all this was over. But you deserve something for getting me out of there alive. Hope you find something useful down there when you manage to make it back there. So it seems we have a situation at hand here, and the Daedric cult knows of our presence here. I think we need to step up our plan and involve you. Assuming you're willing. I'll do what I can. Yes.
Great.
Then I'll entrust my shard to you. Protect it well. Aha. So we got a jewel fragment. Well then, that just leaves Ulgarg's shard. I received a letter from him some weeks ago that he was going to be traveling over the Western Mountains into Skyrim, but that the weather was quite harsh and he would be delayed for some time. He planned on staying at the Orc stronghold Dushnik-Njal to wait out the weather after he made it over the mountains. I'd try there first. Alright, so should we go back to Pale Pass and go to the vaults? I'm going to say yes, but let's go get our new companion to take part in the war. I'd really like to get rid of this guy. I really would. But, yeah, let's go get our newest companion from Riverwood. Alright, we're here in the Sleeping Giant Inn, and there's our new companion, Celine Kate.
What can I do
for you? Needless to say, she is one of my favorites, too.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Alright, you're coming with us. Now, you need to go away.
Lead the way.
Alright, you follow me? And, oh, okay. Let's, command... Dismiss.
I'll head back.
No, that doesn't mean follow me. It doesn't mean it. I assure you, if I tell you...
Lead the way.
Okay, come on. Come it. Wait here. The hunter is waiting for you. Good. You can stay. We don't need you in this battle. Okay, now we're going to go back to Pale Pass. So, onward we go, and I will show you the amazing awesomeness that is Celine Kate. Get that hunter shit off my bars. Off my screen. It's going to kill me. Alright, so what makes Celine Kate so good? Come on. Come up here just a little bit. Come on.
Hello, friend.
All right.
Make yourself at home.
Let's enjoy something. Let's dance together.
Let's try to enjoy ourselves.
And there's a number of different songs here, and you actually have to go in and add the music. I did go in and add it. But let's go with... let's see. There's so many songs here. Let's go with Let's go with Love and Joy. Some of you guys might know some of these songs. And it's amazing. Like, it just adds so much to the game. There was actually a point when I was doing Skyrim playthroughs that, like, you know, whenever, like in RPGs and stuff, you get the little victory fanfare whenever you, like, win a battle. Well, I was doing that, like, every time that... every time that I would finish, that I would finish a dungeon, I would do this. So, anyway, they will just dance the song out. So, but yeah, I was doing it, like, every time I'd finish a dungeon just for fun, like, oh, we finished, let's do a victory dance. And, yeah, it's something. But yeah, if you download her, you have to actually go in and download the songs and add them in. However, there was a person that posted, actually a couple people I know of that posted in the forums and just have it all right there so you can just download it, you know, if you're interested in dancing characters on your game. But also, she's a really badass follower, though, too. It's like a thunderstorm whenever you take her out to battle. It's crazy. All right. Hey, buddy! The Imperial Jailer. Get him. Oh. Nope, no mercy for you. You ever notice, though, if you do show them mercy and don't kill them, they'll just get back up and start fighting and get the hell out of my way. What are we looking for? Oh, tower unlock. And it still doesn't do anything. I love it. I need to get that changed over to, like, the lady again, I guess. Okay, oh my god. What's this place? This isn't even like... I actually do need a skull. Actually. To make the Botema skull for our... for our horde. Alright. Oh, speaking of, I actually bought the movie Warcraft the other day. And I haven't had a chance to watch all of it yet. I started watching it last night. And I watched through, I think, like the first half. But it was pretty late. And I was, like, falling asleep. So I was like, well, okay. There's a guy in here. but so far, I have to say, it's really, really good. Of course, you know, I used to play a lot of Warcraft. And then World of Warcraft I was hooked on for a very, very, very long time. So I have a feeling... Oh, there's a cell key. How is this a vault? This doesn't even resemble a vault. Okay, there's like nothing in that cell or that jail area. Celine's like, I'm holding this area. It's like just playing with ragdolls. I love how she throws that shield up and just goes running in. Like, she is out for blood right now. Ball! Get out of my way. I've got the power of Celine Kate with us. There may be another entrance to a vault or something. I can't find anything down there. And surely her, like, gift to us, if we ever came back this way, wasn't just a pile of bones. Alright, let's finish this. We'll explore the downstairs area. And then we'll go upstairs. So I just walked out of Pell Pass, and this is what I come outside to find. It's absolutely ridiculous. It's like they were just like building up while I was inside or something. So much murdering to be done here. Like, it's like... Hey. It's like horrendous and beautiful at the same time. God. I'm just trying to get out of here. Okay, this is the other fort. It looks like they have a catapult that's setting sideways. It's attacking. Okay, this is the gates to Cyrodiil. requires a key. I'm assuming that's the Stormcloak's little area here. They've got this this catapult just on its side there. Alright, welcome back. I'm actually recording this the next day. I had a little bit of an issue, but I think I've got it solved. I think so. I hope so. Basically, it was happening due to the Dwemer ruin that's up here. Up in this general direction. So let's see, what do we want to use our level up on? Bleed and debuff rank of incoming attacks is reduced by 1. Yes, please. We'll go ahead and grab that so we don't get quite so much bleed effect. That's right. But anyway, I'm on my way to the Orc Stronghold, and all of a sudden, like, there was like this mega war going on. Oh my god, I'm about dead. And actually behind me there's a lightning Atronach. Storm Atronach. Oh god, there's more of these guys. Good god. Okay. Oh my god. I'm about to die. This is insanity. Like, I just teleported to the cave, that Pure Water Run over here, and then this ensued. I don't know who that guy is. Orc Hunter? Probably blocking. I'm just excited to be back on the game. Yeah, like, this massacre is what has ensued. I've never seen such. And then I made some changes and everything, got everything sorted, and now a crazy amount of shit spawning. Now let's go ahead and take the blades. It's cool. Not about here.
Are you saying you don't
trust
me?
Yeah, I don't
trust
you.
Fair point, actually. I wouldn't trust
you. Alright. And like I said, I'm recording this the next day afterwards, because it did take a little while to get the issue all sorted and everything. I want the ancient set too. I'm telling you, I'm a hoarder. Oh, it's coming to life.
You're no fun.
But I don't know if... I can't remember if you guys were with me when I got rid of, Celine Kate. She was just a little bit OP, I feel like. So, ended up tossing her for, at least right now, the Skeever King. Okay. Come on. There's a big-ass skeever. You have anything? Are you special? I don't guess so. Okay. Anyway, back on track. Let's go get this Amulet of Kings taken care of. I'm really hoping that this fixed it. I really am. Basically, I just downloaded a mod that it was a Skyrim like comprehensive bug fixes or something. Downloaded that, and it seems to be okay. I can actually get close to this area now, where in the past I kept crashing when I got anywhere within sight of like this area, which.
Halt, Outlander, by the code of Malekith.
The stronghold belongs to the orcs. You're kind or unwelcome. I go where I please, orc.
But we don't want you here.
How can I convince you to let me in?
We've heard whispers of an enchanted pair of gauntlets.
Hidden and protected by dangerous men, beasts, or worse. They're called the Forgemaster's Fingers. Bring them to our chief, and he will decide if you're worthy to be bloodkin to the orcs. I'll find those gauntlets. Actually, I probably won't. I'll probably go find them after I deal with you guys. I don't give up special things. You should know that by now. I'm a museum collector of epic proportions. Hello, buddy.
You have no business in our stronghold.
I don't care. I don't care about none of that.
Not at all.
Alright, let's see. Any good loots around these parts? I'm just kind of waiting for the orcs to get pissed and be like, well, fuck you, you're dying. Because I will have to murder all of them, actually. Okay. Who are we talking to here? What's up here? The Dunshkink Mines. These names are too difficult. But yeah, sorry about no episode yesterday. Generally, if I don't release an episode, it's probably because I'm having issues, honestly. So we got a note from Olgarg. Get that shit off there. It says, thanks for the food and warm bed, brothers, but I best get on my way. There are Morong Tong bastards on my heels, and if I stay any longer, I could endanger you all. Malakath, smile on you. I'll be heading east, so if anyone comes looking, send them west, will you? Olgarg. Okay. Well, so we should be headed east then. Let's see.
You aren't very talkative, are you? I always open.
Oh, we've got a marker like right. Locate Olgarg's camp. Okay. And we've got a Dwemer dragon up there too, so this could be bad. Could be bad. Alright, so we have discovered his camp, and there's arrows. Oh noes. Alright, I'll take that and that. He won't be needing them, I bet. So follow his trail? The fuck? Follow his trail to where? Ridgecliff Cave? Really? We gotta go there for a quest. For one of our Daedric quests. So onward we go. Oh god. It is running so good right now. Like, this is the first time I've been able to just freely run around in the Reach and not be like CTD heavy time. So I do think we have got this finally sorted out. Killing machine achievement. By the way, we've actually built up a fair good amount of achievement, so let's really, really quickly check that out really, really fast. So achieve that and Hall of Glory. So we have 130 total, but we have 105 available to us at the moment. So let's go ahead and get, do we want all damage? I feel like I want all damage plus 5%. Let's take all damage plus 5%. And then let's take speed, maybe? Speed. Then we could also get like stamina regen. Or elemental resistance. Speed or let's get speed because we're kind of slow actually. And then let's get stamina regen because I feel like all of that will come in handy. Like being able to move around on the battlefield a little bit quicker will definitely help us out. It's not like super noticeable, but you know, it adds up. Especially being in heavy armor like this. Oh my gosh, we can actually finally complete this Daedric quest. That's been killing me.
You've come. The Draugr infesting the Mirror Sanctuary are inside.
Wait here, I'll take care of them. I wouldn't make you come with us. But yeah, I got rid of Selene Kate, and I'm probably just going to take, I don't know, somebody. If you guys have a suggestion for a follower to add, I'll definitely give it a shot. But Selene Kate, she's already on the weakest stat that she can be in, and she's like rocking shit. I mean, granted, I could get rid of her spells. Maybe. We might try that out. Because, like, I really like her. But she's just a little bit too OP, I feel like. Okay. You need to die, sir. Alright. As you near Olgarg's body, Your shards start to glow, and then you notice a distinct glow from Olgarg's stomach. Uh-oh. Where the hell is he going? He's like, fuck this place. Okay. So, Olgarg, beast right here. What the fuck? What?
They say exits be glad in
the... Searching. So I'll let my weapons do the talking. Okay, maybe we've got to cut him open. You cut into the gut of Olgarg and extract a gem fragment. Apparently he swallowed the gem in order to safeguard it. What a hero. Alright, so we need to return to Argus at High Hrothgar. But let's go ahead and finish this Daedric quest because we are the ultimate Daedric worshiper. You get the hell out of my way. God, it's just a blockade of shitheads here. There. Ah.
Get you some of that.
Okay. Oh, son of a... Oh, cool. Cool times. Okay. And actually, this is probably my favorite Daedric quest. Not for the content of the quest, but just the backstory and stuff is really hella cool, I think. Hello, I know you're going to come to life. But I hear your friend wandering about the halls.
What was that? Draugr Scourge! Get you some, son!
Okay. Good stuff. Good stuff.
What was that? Now you're mine.
Shit. Don't shoot it that way. These people. I need to get rid of this hunter, actually. Because he is driving me insane because I don't want him with me right now.
You are an abomination.
Come on.
Get you some.
Okay. I'm going to go back up here and really, really quick and check on, there was a side passage back here. And I've noticed that in the past, like our Daedric stuff that we're wearing, like the Daedric Lord's Cuirass and things like that, we have found in these, like during the process of doing these Daedric quests. So, I want to be safe and make sure that we obtain everything. Oh, you know, I forget that I have Whirlwind Shout. Like, I just totally forget it. It's the one I have equipped right now. I just totally forget that I've got it. Alright. But yeah, when we were, like, exploring that old library, for example, we missed that helmet. So, I want to be on the safe side to you. Oosh. Let's check it. Guard of Builders 4 and 20 gold. And Dwarven Armor, but that doesn't count because we don't want it. If we don't want it, it didn't exist. That's our reasoning. Okay. It's kind of interesting that Olgarg was in the same location of, a Daedric quest. I know, you're going to bust out of that shit. I feel like we're moving like extra slow right now. Maybe the speed thing just had a negative effect on us. So we got a conjuration book. Yes. Okay. Nothing this way. Oh my gosh. I'm so happy that we can actually move forward with this stuff. Watch this. Oh. Go back down. Go back down. Because we weren't able to explore the Reach like at all before, and it just... it killed my soul, because, like, that's a big chunk of the game that's like, nope, you can't go in that area. You're not allowed to go in that area, so we've got a door here. God, what weapon does he have? It's like Mega Scimitar Man. We've got an archer up in there, at least. Ebony Dowdow. What the hell? That is a ton of damage. Let's grab that. Let me see. Is that more damage than what we're using? No. Okay. We have 476 on this. Scratch that. What the fuck? Let's go ahead and save. That didn't look friendly at all. You shut your mouth. Oh god, them spells over here though. What the hell? Something just bodied the shit out of me. Okay. Let's try this again. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and save right there, just in case. Just to be on the safe side. God. He has like a mega debuff when I get near it. Let's all get him. God, he does so much damage. Okay. Oh my god. Oh my god. That damage though. That damage! Okay, he shoots out like ice whenever he attacks, and that's the bad stuff. That is the very, very bad things. Let's pop a resist ice pot. Okay, we've almost got him. Oh my god. Hardest Draugr ever. The Phoenix Ninjato Katana. Let's take it. Speak to Yola. Okay. Is there anything? I'm gonna check these because I didn't see a Relics of Hyrule thing outside. But still, ever since then, ever since finding that song page in the damn burial urn, I'm gonna check all of these. Alright. We've got a Card of Shadows 3. Yeah, let's take it. And that Oil of Fire Deadly. Okay. A couple of those. Watch, ever since I just added that one little mod, I'll include it in the, you know, in the mod list. It'll be at the bottom. So if you guys are having, you know, any kind of crash issues, I definitely suggest it because it fixed mine. So I don't know, but if you're having any kind of issues at all, like I was, just random CTDs in a place, download that, and I think if you still crash, it's going to give you a reason as to why as well, from the way I understand it. So, it's a really, really nice mod, and, like, from what I saw, it was just updated, like, August, I think. So, they're still on top of it, which is definitely awesome, you know. Because we need, with Skyrim as it is right now, hopefully the remaster will be a different case. But as Skyrim is right now, we need all the bug fixes we can get. We need them all. Okay, she must have come in behind us. I will say that our stamina regen is very noticeable. Like, watch this. Bam! It goes back up. The shrine is ours again. Just tell me who needs to die. That's right. Alright, convince Varilus to follow you. Let's go do it. Sorry that I missed missed her the first time. So we'll go get him. This just takes but a second. And it's actually probably one of the coolest scenes in Skyrim. I love this part. Absolutely love it. By the way, even though, like, you know, I'm still not 100% sure everything is just fixed, I feel like my game's a lot more stable now. Like,
what happened to the Hall of the Dead?
The Hall of the Dead is safe now.
Here,
take my amulet as a reward. Thanks. I need a priest.
Yes. Busy in Markarth.
I don't know. There'd be treasure to share. Oh yeah, you're greedy little shit. That's gonna come back to bite you in the ass. Come on, guy. Let's go priest it up a little bit. So now we just gotta run him back over to the tomb, to the catacombs. But yeah, over, you know, I'll notice fairly quickly. You know, that's one reason I save so much, and that's why my screen locks up. I just have it set so I don't have to go through menus, because that would just be a pain for you guys and everything. But that's why. I'll show you. I killed like the entire Imperial army. I don't need you. Yes, right here. You know, that's the reason I save so much, is because of the damn just crashing. So, you know, over the next couple days, I'll see very, very quickly, you know, if it crashes as much. Because, yeah, in here. That was just kind of a thing, you know, after I played it for very long at all, it would crash. And then, of course, anytime I came into the Reach, it would crash. Well, the Reach crashes seem to be null and void. And it almost feels like Immersive Creatures is, like, finally kicking in, because, you know, I've had those extra spawns turned on, but that was the first time when we had all those undead show up, that was, like, the first time I'd really seen it, I guess. Hey. Dirty face. Dirty face.
Who are you? What's going on?
We're hungry.
Priest of RK. I'm your friend.
You're my friend?
Yes.
Yes, I'm your friend. And I've invited you to dinner.
I've been invited to dinner.
Yes.
So hungry.
Why don't you lay down and rest while we get the meal ready?
Yes.
Watch what we're doing.
Fuck off.
I'll just be a minute.
Fucking come on. If you haven't ever noticed, there's actually a lot of people in here that you probably recognize. Not some of these guys. They're around, but some of them are actually kind of more important. I think Hogni Redarm and some of these people. I can't remember. It's been a while since I just, you know, played vanilla and, you know, really paid attention to all these people. She's trying to, like, find me, I think. Okay. Let's do business.
The meal is on Namira's table. Go ahead. Carve.
Okay. Let me carve. Let me carve that shit. Fucking come on. Where's the thing to carve it? I wanna carve it, damn it. Fuck off. I can't figure out how to carve this shit. Yes, I wanna bring this I want to bring this down. Fucking come on.
Don't be shy. You should be the one to call.
Oh, that's right. I don't think it. I think I just kill him, right? Fuck off!
I'm on your side.
Have the first bite.
I forgot. Alright. Let's eat his body. Nom 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 nom.
Mortal. I am Namira, the Lady of Decay. Your consumption of the blood and bile of Arkay's own is pleasing to me. I give you my ring. Wear it, and when you feast on the flesh of the dead, I will grant you my power.
She's so, like, sexual about it. My power. Thank you, m'lady.
Wallow in your wretchedness, my newest champion. I knew when you walked into the Hall of the Dead that you were special.
Yes.
The dead exist to feed the living.
Boogity boogity boogity. Boogity boogity boogity. But anyway, you can go through and you can talk to these people. And they'll tell you a bit about their history and all that. But it's vanilla, so let's move on. Alright, so now we can eat dead bodies if we wear that ring. I might actually get... There's a mod I used to run that lets you wear multiple rings, because it only makes sense, like, who only has one finger, right? Stamina is increased by 50 points. Feeding on corpses grants you increased health and health regen. It's actually a really nice ring. You know, if you have, like, humanoids to eat and get your cannibalism on. So we may end up adding the mod that lets us wear, like, multiple rings. I usually set it to 4. I feel like that's fair, especially with the difficulty mods. I feel like that's fair without just being overly ridiculous. Like, I don't know. I feel like 10 rings. I don't know who in their right mind would wear 10 rings, you know. But we might end up adding that in just because it would kind of be nice. Especially for rings like that, like, you know, I really don't want to get rid of my two-handed weapon ring. Like, that's like a big chunk of damage right there. Alright, so let's turn this in. I made it. Ah, you're back. Oh, but you don't have old Grog with you. That's not a good sign. He was dead when I found him. Sad to hear, but at least you managed to find the shard. Olgarg was quite clever for an orc. Hiding it in his own stomach, quick thinking. I didn't tell you that. Now all that's left to do is get the gold setting of the amulet. Unfortunately, the enemy already has it. It will require a direct attack on the Morong Tong. They don't respond well to subtlety. God. And negotiation. I'll mark where they are operating from. Once you find the setting, meet us back here. Alright. Find the Morong Tong hideout at Raven's Rest. So that quest will take us... No, it's not there. It's not there. It's here. Ha ha. So we need to go over there. Good stuff. I do think we will end out the episode there. I know it's about wrapping up point. And do let me know in the comments. I know, like, here lately I've done less time-lapse stuff. You know, the speed ups and the music and all that stuff. I've done less of that. And I want to know if you guys prefer, you know, if you want the time lapses or if you don't. I was just kind of doing like a test, you know, so to speak. So if you guys want the time lapses back, of course we can cover more content, but I don't know how it is watching for you guys, you know, when it's sped up like that. So if you will, let me know if you guys prefer the time lapse or you'd rather me keep it like this. And I will do my best to adjust it. And hopefully, fingers crossed, our game runs like a boss from now on. And we no longer have any days where I can't get an episode out for you guys. So, I'm going to hope. I have a good feeling this time. I have a really good feeling. Like, that's the first time I've been able to go to the Reach in a long time. So, super excited. But anyway, if you guys enjoyed the video, be sure and hit that like button and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. And feel free to comment. Let me know what you think. And definitely, if you will, let me know what you think about the time lapses, because, you know, I really want you guys' input on that, if you'd rather have them or you'd rather not. Because, you know, I'm trying to get these videos to where they're the best for you guys to enjoy, you know, as the viewers and everything. And by the way, we may start adding back our texture mods. If you notice, I did take the grasses and stuff back out when I was bug testing. We may start adding those back in, assuming that everything runs smoothly. So, hopefully so. And we can make it look pretty again. So, but anyway, I'm going to end out the episode there, and I will quit talking your ears off. So until next episode, as always, do take care, and I do hope to see you guys next time.